But I will try to keep it as concise, as precise as possible. So I'm going to start with the obvious. It's like a disclaimer that we all are aware of, but I will say it nonetheless, that there are no coincidences in Guruji's Darbar. So everything that happens is a part of his design. So I'll give you a little background about how I'm here. Last week, before planning this lightning trip to India, I was like, Guruji, bahut time ho gaya. I want to plan a spiritual retreat with you, only for 5 days. But in those 5 days, I want to go to the Bada Mandir. I want to do Dugri. I want to do Jalandhar. I want to do Empire State. I want to do Greater Kailash. Panch jaga, panch din. So even before I told my parents that I'd booked the ticket at a 2-day notice, I texted my soul sister Khushbu and I said, you know what, Khushbu, I'm coming and this is a trip that is dedicated to Guruji, so just make it happen. And as uncle said, ke zariya to, you know, ban jata hai, par karne karane wale Guruji hai, but if you have a brother like Gaurav and a sister like Khushbu, so, you know, Guruji ki kripa is very evident. So anyway, 22nd I land, and the first question my dad asked was, you're flying out on 27th, ek satsang hai yahan par, will you be able to attend that? And I was like, yeah, I have a flight later tonight, so probably, you know, Guruji ki ichha hui to zarur I'll attend that. And the day I landed, I go to Bada Mandir, I'm sitting in the langar room, aur peeche Aruna aunty baithi hai, aur saath mein Sudh aunty was sitting. और ये आपस में बात कर रहे थे कि हम गुरुजी से पूछ रहे हैं आज सत्संग किसका कराएं. And I'm like, oh God, you know, मेरे तक बारी ना आए. And I didn't even turn my face. And I think she told my dad कि आप सत्संग करो. And dad's like, नहीं, मेरी बेटी आई हुई वो करेगी. I was like, चलो हो गया काम. So that's the reason I'm here. And I'm very, very excited to share my journey with you all. So flashback 1999, I was a young college student with a very impressionable mind and I believed that I was very rational and very logical and I like to question the status quo. So obviously, you know, going to a guru was not on my priority list, but jab bulawa aata hai, to Guruji ka bulawa aata hai and he chooses your soul. So please do not think that you are here because you're somebody's daughter or somebody's wife. You are here because Guruji ne aapki soul ko chuna apne darbar mein bulane ke liye and congratulate yourselves that aap jannat mein baithe ho. So anyway, one fine night, meri bhi bari aayi. And the night before that, my parents had gone to Guruji and they came back home at 3 o'clock in the morning. So I was, you know, I was talking to my sister Pooja. I said, ye kaun se Guruji ke paas gaye ki aadhi raat tak wapas hi nahi aaye. And my mom came back and she had a handful of sweets, candies, toffees. She said, ye lo Guruji ne bheja hai and Guruji ne kaha hai ki aarti puja ko kal lekar aana. So I was like, okay, chalte hain. And just to level set, the very first day my parents went, my mom is a diabetic. And diabetic to the extent that she injects herself 4 times a day with insulin to keep her sugar level normal. So the day that, she went, Guruji Maharaj, as loving, as magnanimous, as gracious as he is, kabhi amrati, kabhi barfi, kabhi laddu ka prashad. And my mom is like so hesitant, ke, oh God, aaj to mere karam sare kat gaye, mera kaam ho gaya. So she goes back home and, you know, we like to think that we are very logical and we like to question things. And Kaliyug hai, we don't accept things as is, right? Wo shak to karna hi hota hai. So sure enough, she pricked herself with a sugar machine and she saw her reading 110. Now, itni dawaiyan kha kar bhi, unka sugar level has never been that normal. And I can bet there are more than half a dozen doctors sitting in house today. You tell me which science, which logic can justify this. So that's when, you know, when science fails and all your logic fails, that's when your faith starts to build. And I was like, wow, this is amazing. I think, you know, there is no phenomena that can explain this. So anyway, when I went, and as I said, everybody's journey is an independent journey. I went with an open mind, like a sponge, I wanted to absorb everything. And as uncle was describing in his satsang, my impression was quite the same. Guruji was sitting on his beautiful red chair, I think in a light pink, beautiful chola. And a man as radiant as him, ke chehre pe itna noor, unka jo aura tha, matlab chehre se nazar nahi hat rahi thi, aur aisa lag raha tha ki hum indralok mein pravesh kar gaye. And you know, ek aunty kandha dabari, ek haath dabari, ek pair dabari, as a ye, you know, acha scene hai. So जाकर बैठ गए. Now there was some feel good factor about that place. There was something about that place that kept you coming back again and again. And आज तो dime a dozen, you know, do's and don'ts circulate होते हैं. ये करो, ये मत करो. Back in those days, there were no do's and don'ts. There was no discourse that was given. We would learn by observing our fellow sangat and seeing what is, you know, being done. So anyway, जाकर बैठ गए and the crowd was very elite, creme de la creme of Delhi. And, you know, you start forming impressions being a human being. Ke, you know, agar ye Guruji hai, then why is he asking people to press his hands and feet? Tab satsang bhi hota tha. Now we understand the mahima of satsang, that Guruji does not need our marketing. Satsang hota hai hamare khud ke karam katne ke liye. It's a way of offering your gratitude to your guru. So, jab satsang hua to mere dimaag mein aur bhi khayal aaya ki, you know, agar Guruji ne kisi ka kalyan kiya bhi hai, then why publicize? So these questions started to come to my mind, but I did not go home and discuss ke aisa kya hai, kyun hai, and how Guruji gave me answers to all of that, you know, I want to share with you. So my first personal experience was ke mera kuch din mein economics ka exam tha, and I'm very free spirited, you know, I don't fear anything. If I have to ask something, I will. So I went up to Guruji and I said, chutti later time, I said, Guruji, mera economics ka paper hai. Maine itna hi bola. And Guruji started asking me questions on elasticity, demand, supply. And jisse pehle main ek sawal ka jawab deti, second question, and the third question. And I was like, if he's not interested in hearing my answers, why is he asking me these questions? To ek aunty jo unko ghut rahi thi, unke pair daba rahi thi, she said, beta note karo, Guruji aapka question paper bata rahe. Meri to aankhein khul gayi. I said, yahan sirf buzurg theek nahi hote, yahan to question paper bhi leak ho jata hai. So I was like, amazing. Maine fatafat wo questions note kiye, ghar ja ke maine padha. And Sangat ji, believe you me, next day, there is no way without his mahima, I could have passed my economics exam with distinction. Because wohi questions aaye. Tab se mera to it was like game changer. So, uske baad, you know, subsequent things happened. I was in college one day and I had my dad's cell phone. So, you know, I was pacing up class nahi thi, hum campus mein bahar ghoom rahe the. So phone bajta hai and I pick up, you know, this random call. Now those of you who have met Guruji, you know, you will know ki Guruji ki jo awaaz hai na, that's very very surreally, very very, you cannot forget his voice. So maine phone uthaya, so awaaz aayi, ki kar rahi hai? Maine kaha, oh Guruji. And instantly I started walking ahead of my friends. I said, ye to beizzati ho jayegi, log bolenge isko guru log phone karte hain. So maine kaha, Guruji, and he said, ha. Maine kaha, Guruji, aaj na papa ka phone mere paas hai. Like, we are so shallow and kuch pata nahi hota, to innocence mein maine bolti, aise, Guruji, aaj papa ka phone mere paas hai. Daddy, the phone tere kol hai? Maine kaha, haan ji Guruji. Te shaami aa jayi? Maine kaha, ji Guruji. ते डैडी नु नाल लेकर आए? जी गुरुजी. ते मामा नु घर चढ़ के आए? मैं कहा, जी गुरुजी. मैंने फटाफट जी 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 करके फोन रखा ताकि कोई मुझसे सवाल ना पूछे. एंड श्योर इनफ कॉलेज खत्म किया, वापसी पे डैड को उठाया, घर गए एंड फटाफट जाके तैयार होने लगे. सो माई मॉम आस्क्ड, अच्छा कहाँ जा रहे हो? हमने कहा, गुरुजी के पास. अच्छा मैं भी आती हूँ. ऐसा नहीं, आप ठंड रखो, आपको मना किया. सो शी वॉज डिसअपॉइंटेड, बट गुरुजी का हुक्म इज गुरुजी का हुक्म, इट्स पत्थर की लकीर. So we went that day and there was no sangat in the darbar. He was sitting in his bedroom on a couch playing with his phone. Guruji ko observe karne mein bahut maza aata tha. Ab samajh aata ki wo mahashiv the aur unki jo haathon ki jo mudraen hain, jo unki adaen thi, that was telling us a lot. But I guess hamare upar, you know, aankhon ke upar wo parda pada hua tha, that we could not understand back then that we are face to face with none other than the sole creator of this universe, Mahashiv himself. So anyway, I don't remember ke kya baatcheet hui, but it was a very light conversation. Guruji was very well informed, very well read, and I think we were talking about current affairs. So itne mein fir Guruji ne nariyal pani mangwaya, and unka wo cover hokar aata tha. You couldn't see the, through the glass ke kya wo pee rahe. So he took a sip and then he extended his hand and he said, le pee le. So maine ek gulp mein wo pee liya, and believe you me, that divine nectar. नारियल पानी आप सबने बहुत बार पिया होगा, बट दैट वॉज अमृत. उसका जो टेस्ट था वो मैं बयान नहीं कर सकती. वो दिया, उसके बाद गुरुजी कॉल्ड सम संगत, एंड नाउ यू नो संतो आंटी, आई डोंट नो इफ यू पीपल नो, संतो आंटी को फोन किया एंड ही टॉक टू हर एंड ही सेड, की बनाया है? शी मस्ट हैव सेड समथिंग ओवर द फोन, विच वी फाउंड आउट वॉज राजमा चावल. सो ही सेड, अच्छा कोई गल नहीं, असी पांच सात लोग आ रहे हैं. तो शी सेड, कोई बात नहीं. And the power of these two words, Jai Guruji, is so immense ki aap ek naya rishta kayam kar lete ho without even knowing who you're talking to, just on the basis of these two words. That's the strength of these two words. So anyway, Guruji ka jab pata chala, Colonel Joshi bhi the, wahan bahar the, to Guruji ki gaadi lagi and Guruji stepped out and he said, main General Kapoor ki gaadi mein jaunga. So, sure enough, Papa fada fada ke baithne lage and he said, Joshi naal ja. And I sat with Guruji. Guruji was on this side, I was on this side and saamne Mishra ji the. वो गाड़ी चला रहे थे एंड दैट नाइट यू नो गुरुजी की इतनी मेहर थी दैट आई कुड स्मेल द दस्त द्वार आई डिड नॉट अंडरस्टैंड द मीनिंग ऑफ दैट बट नाउ आई रियलाइज कि पता नहीं गुरुजी किस दिन के लिए मुझे ब्लेसिंग दे रहे थे सो दैट हैपेंड देन आई नोटिस कि संगत में कई बार यू नो ऑन स्पेशल ओकेजन्स लोग चॉकलेट्स लेके जाया करते थे गुरुजी के पास सो जब मेरा भी बर्थडे हुआ तो आई टुक अ बॉक्स ऑफ चॉकलेट्स फॉर गुरुजी And it was my birthday, so maine unko chocolates di. Guruji was wearing beautiful maroon juttis, exactly that color jo roses ka hai. And he took off his juttis and he said, "Le chak tera prashad." And Guruji had a very keen sense of humor. Jab wo meri shakal dekhe, badi changi kudi hai, munda fasale, vyah kara le. Maine, matlab to the point ki main nazar hi chura leti thi ki ye na bol dein Guruji kahin samne se. But his love for Sangat was tremendous. And that pact still continues. So every time it's my birthday, I try to offer a box of chocolates to Guruji because that I feel that's a pact between Guruji and I. I'll fast forward a couple years. 2015, Guruji ka mandir naya naya khula tha in New Jersey. And that time we didn't have a kitchen, so ghar se seva hoti thi. 12th Feb ko maine seva li thi, it was my birthday. So, jaldi jaldi jana tha mandir, I worked and I did my seva and I was like, chalo ab ye langar lekar mandir jate. And I forgot, I said, oh my god, I don't have a box of chocolates for Guruji. Mera to aaj pack toot jayega. So anyways, very sheepishly, I grabbed a few candies, I put it in my pocket and I said, koi baat nahi, it's between Guruji and I will just share these candies. Maine jaake matha teka, but this was on my mind that, oh my god, I'm not able to offer him a box of chocolates. So मैं वहां जाके बैठी there's this auntie who calls me outside. She's like, बेटा आपके लिए इंडिया से किसी ने कुछ भिजवाया है And I thought it must be a box of sweets, पता नहीं क्या I go to the langar room, I open, it's a box of chocolates. So this is his way of showing his love. And I think we're on a time crunch and I can go on. But one last satsang that happened today. So I was in GK and आई थॉट यू नो मंदिर बंद है तो मैंने बाहर यू नो एक नारियल वाला जा रहा था तो मैंने उसको बुलाया सर हम जिसको हैंग आउट ऑन द रोड जब तक मंदिर खुलता है सो मैंने नारियल पानी पीना शुरू कर दिया राइट आउटसाइड इज दरबार उसके बाद यू नो आई स्पोक टू खुशबू शी सेड नो जस्ट पुट योर हैंड इन यू नो खोलकर अंदर चले जाओ सो आई वेंट इन एंड आई सैट डाउन सो उसके बाद आंटी सर की अच्छा आके आप गुरु जी का कमरा देख लो मैंने मत्था टेका And I don't know why we started, you know, got into satsang sharing and this coconut water ka thing came up. And she's like, why didn't you bring coconut water for Guruji today? I said, auntie, it's strange you say that because as I was sipping on this coconut water right outside the darbar, this came to my mind as well. But I did not want to be rude and bring in something, you know, food into the mandir. She's like, nahin, aap lekar aao Guruji ke liye. So sure enough, I went out, wahan coconut wale ka namo nishan nahin nazar aa raha. Main 20 minute tak ghoomti rahi. I said, Guruji, if you want a coconut, just help me find one. Sure enough, I see a coconut, I come in. She's like, ab jao iska bhog chadao. So I went into the room. I sat down for Guruji with less, you know, for less than 2 minutes. And he spoke to me in Punjabi. My Punjabi is not great, but he said something to the effect of, you know, X number of years ago, I think 15, 16, 17 years ago, you had offered me coconut water. And today, you know, I had offered you coconut water. And today you're offering me coconut water. So this voice came in my mind. It's like telepathy that Guruji is talking to you directly. And I start crying. You know, and this was in Punjabi, I left the room. So auntie's like, beta, aapko andar baithna hai. I said, nahi auntie, I cannot sit in that room. The vibration is tremendous. So I sat down chup chap kone mein, and that auntie says to me in Punjabi, Guruji keh rahe honge na, ki 17 saal pehle tu mainu coconut pila ke gayi hai. Those exact words that I heard in my mind in the room, she said it to me, and again I start crying. So the bottom line is that Guruji is real. He's with each one of us. The only parting comment that I can leave with all of us here is that it takes strength to do the difficult, but it takes faith to do the impossible. So faith, surrender, unconditional love, and shukrana. Jai Guruji, Jai Guruji.